Hey, I'm Sasha Zverev and you're Inside Tennis with The Cos.
Nick Bellatieri, you were there at day one when the Eddie Herr International arrived. How much impact has that event had on the game, and how proud is IMG to have it right here?
Well, first of all, the Eddie Herr tournament that's being hosted by IMG is very unique. Why so? It's one of the few locations in the world that the entire event can be held on one venue. When you go down to the Orange Bowl, it's at about 6 or 7 sites. So if a coach has more than one student, it is very difficult. Also, the safety procedure of all the kids that come here are very, very safe. And to be able to have an event like the Eddie Herr at the IMG Academy on one venue is just fantastic.
Well, Jimmy Arias, there was a time that you were a 15-year-old kid also. You turned pro, though, so you got out of the junior tennis scene. But what do you enjoy most about what you're seeing in today's junior tennis?
Well, look, I think these players are amazing. And especially, I know we watch a lot of the 18-and-unders now, but the 12-and-unders, I cannot believe how good some of these kids are. They look like little adults ripping the ball. You didn't see that back in my day. Obviously, so
just you though.
I was the first
one ripper.
Well, that was why I was doing well when I was young. So it's nice to see that the game has evolved to that in a sense. Although it worries me that you don't see the variety anymore that we used to see. You don't see many people coming in. You don't see that skill as a lost art, and that disturbs me a little bit. Makes it less fun.
Colette Lewis. Many of these young kids say, "Who's Eddie Herr? What's Eddie Herr?" And you and I both know the impact that this guy has made on competitive junior tennis. Share a couple of thoughts that you have about Eddie Herr.
When I first started covering junior tennis, which was about 15 years ago, Eddie Herr was already a legend. And when you would come here, his portrait was always up in the indoor facility, and kids would have their picture taken next to it, an oil painting of Eddie. And he had already entered legendary status.
On the domestic side, how strong of a showing did the Yanks have? I can give you one stat that I did. It appeared that there were 30 players in the quarterfinals or better boys and girls events. How strong is that, Colette?
That's very good. And traditionally, they have the United States has had very good representation here at the Eddie Herr over the years.
Your selection, I know we don't give it officially every year, but this year it's the Colette Lewis Rising Star. Who caught your eye this year, Colette?
I have to say that is not hard for me. It was Maximus de Salt in the 12s. He's small, he's only 11, but just the game style is so much fun to watch.
Eddie Herr, 12 and under champion. It has a nice ring to it. What's that ring sound like to you today?
Very good. I'm very happy about it. It was a great match from both of us. Neither one of us deserved to lose. It was a great match.
Max, you grew up here at IMG.
Yes.
What's it like coming back and then seeing one of your country win the title today?
Well, it's certainly a feeling of coming a full circle. Not only that I've come here as a student, I continue to use this facility, amazing facility, to this day. I have recently stopped my professional career, but this area in general, IMG Academy, has served me very well, and I consider it a home away from home. It's great to see another successful story from Belarus come here at the Eddie Herr Academy, and I'm great that I was able to witness it today.
Max Mirny, your coach from Belarus, He is so excited that you won. How excited are you to have won this for your country and for your coach, Max Mirny?
That she's so glad that she has that kind of coach, Max, and together they will do a lot of more matches, winning matches.
For me, I'm so happy and I wanted to win so much. So I'm happy, and for the country, I don't know, maybe they are happy, but...
I'm sure that they are. Well, Madison, what a great week it was. You got to the finals. Some nice things about the finals. You may have not got the last winning point, but boy, you were playing a friend also from Everett Academy. What's that like?
It's always hard playing my friend, but it was a really great opportunity that we were both in the finals and played a good match.
Oh, it's amazing. It's a really big tournament, one of the biggest of the year, and I'm really confident going into the rest of the season and the beginning of next year.
It's very exciting to have two of your players opposing one another in the final, but behind the scene, how do you coach one? How do you coach the other? Share that with us. Not everybody knows how to handle that.
Well, with both of these girls, they've really excelled in the last couple years, and they've had to play each other two or three times now, deeper in tournaments. So it's a tough thing, but both girls are pretty mature, pretty professional. They both want to be professional tennis players one day, so if that's going to be the case, you are going to be playing your friends quite often.
Well, I couldn't believe it. Nobody could believe it. You were down four match points. You dodged four bullets. And you came back firing.
To be honest, we started really like bad. It was windy so much. We didn't find our game from before matches. We were a little bit nervous. We wanted to win. And I don't know, then one point changed everything. Then we started to fight more, to be more motivated. And then we were a little bit lucky then, and we won.
You two have a friendship going, but what does winning a international ITF title do for a friendship? How much better does that make a friendship?
Well, it makes it, I think, very good. I mean, our friendship is always at the top level, and it will keep at the same level. And even if we didn't win today, it will be, I think, the same.
Well, Anya and Elizabeth, you never played together before. All of a sudden, you team up and you win the Eddie Herr doubles. What's that like?
It's pretty fun. I mean, we just texted each other and we ended up playing, and we didn't expect to win. I mean, we expected that we had a chance, but not that we were gonna win.
What's the chemistry with a new time team like?
Oh, we were friends before, so it was easy, but we just feel each other good on the court.
Quinlan, first of all, congratulations on a very mysterious, exciting match out there. That could have gone either way. Everybody felt that. What finally turned it in your direction? How did you close that one out?
Because, you know, I have a tough first set. And from I lost the first set, I say, okay, I'm going to fight and to see how it goes. And from the second set and third set, I play much more relaxed than the first set. And also, I keep focusing on my mind. That's why I can win. And it was so tough match, yeah.
Very tough.
I want to say thank you for the people are supporting me, because, you know, last week I lose second round from GA. And normally I was supposed to don't play ID here because I lose all my confidence and I just want to practice. But the people around me, my team, my agent and the coach from ITF team and my mom, they were supporting me so much. They were saying, it's okay, let's keep going, you can do it. And but last week, I cannot even think about it. I can win champion from here. Thank you so much for my team and for my agent, my coach, my mom. Thank you so much for them.
Wow. Wow. Wow.
Because, you know, if you lose second round, you can't think about champion after. This was a big win for me, really important.
Very good. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And boy, did you give a gift to IMG. You gave them a champion today.
Yeah.
How great of a feeling does that give you?
Great, great. I mean, I think I actually thought about this when Eddie here was coming up
to be able to win the Eddie Herr in my last year of juniors is great. And nothing, I'm really thankful for this academy, for this, for all the people that work with me, not only my coach, but all the coaching staff, all the people who help me out, the maintenance, everyone. It just makes me feel like my second home, and I'm extremely happy I was able to win this tournament.
You play at the highest level of competition for your country, Davis Cup. What's that mean to a young guy like you?
Amazing, amazing. I played in Argentina against Argentina. I don't think there's a better meaning of Davis Cup than playing against Argentina there. And those are the moments that I work for, live for, and representing my country is the best thing that tennis has ever given me.
No more practice today. Enjoy the evening. Celebrate well.
Thank you,
Nicholas.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it. But we might come out to practice a little bit. Thank you so much.
Over 1,000 players, 50 countries represented. Mm-hmm. What impact does the IMG Eddie Herr have on junior tennis?
On junior tennis, I think it has a huge impact because every age group is represented. And then I think on the pro side, every winner here has become a professional tennis player of some sort.
Hi, I'm James Blake. You're Inside Tennis with the Cause.